Grundsätzlich ist der Standplatz
des The anchor point is basically the safe haven for a rope team. So any work carried out here needs to be as perfect as possible. There are two types of anchors, series connections with solid protection pieces and distribution of load belays with questionable protection pieces. If your belay uses multiple questionable pieces, perhaps three or more, then distribution of load is a crucial issue. As its name suggests, the aim is to distribute the load equally across all protection pieces so that all pieces absorb the fall tension equally. In addition, if one of the pieces fails, there should be no jerking that could add additional force to the system. If I'm setting up a belay using a sling with multiple questionable pieces, it's best to use a 240-centimeter sling, which is generally long enough to reach between 3 and 5 protection points. That means I can clip the sling once into all pieces. I then pull downwards on all the strands running through the protection points and create a big girth hitch on these strands into which I clip my central carabiner. I can then hook both my personal anchor and partner belay for my follower into this central carabiner. If you use an open Dyneema or Kevlar cord, these have the great advantage that you save on carabiners and can thread them directly into the protection, so your carabiner is not going to get bent by the rock. This method is used mainly in South Tyrol in the Dolomites, which is why it is generally referred to as the South Tyrolean anchor method. The best way is to feed the Dyneema or Kevlar cord through all the protection points. Then, before connecting them, I pull the slings down between the pieces to give me the optimum working height and correct angle, and make sure the sling is not too far below the protection points. If this were the case, the belay could end up flying high into the air. I fix this optimum height by tying an overhand knot. Then I gather up all the slings again to ensure the direction of pull is correct, and finally I make a girth hitch around the central point carabiner. Clipped into this are my personal anchor and partner's belay. Once my anchor is set up, I'm ready to bring up my follower. At this moment, the fall tension on the anchor can only act downwards, not upwards. But as soon as the follower overtakes to lead, the anchor should ideally also withstand upward force. This is done ideally by placing a protection piece below the central point. Or if that isn't possible, then I have to ensure I create a downward direction for the anchor using my body weight. The anchor is the rope team's life insurance in alpine climbing. That's why you need to practice setting up anchors, protection points, and correct belay technique.